Welcome to PDFsupply.com, a global supplier of industrial automation. Today we're going to be testing a GE Series 9030. The part is an IC693CMM321. This particular device is an Ethernet controller. Now I'm going to place it in the rack. I have a 5-slot rack, power supply, CPU, and the Ethernet controller. What we want to do is a full functional test. This particular device reacts to a ping test. First thing that we do, obviously, when we get it is to check to make sure that we have an OK LED, that the device is actually working, and we do. So we'll go ahead and continue with it. And on the programmer here, we're going to configure the device. Communication device, CMM321. It's going to need an IP address in order to communicate with it. And a subnet mask. Those numbers will depend on what you have available to you. You probably want to check with your IT people so that it doesn't confuse with another device. So I've chosen a number that's not going to conflict with anything. And we're going to go ahead and connect up to the CPU. Clear out any present faults. And then we're going to download this scenario. Once CPU is downloaded and I've got these numbers and this configuration all set and the device is in run mode, I'm going to want to do a simple ping test. The way you can do that is go to your start menu and look for your command prompt. If you don't have your command prompt up, you can always do a search for it and it will come up. This is what it should look like when you have it. It looks like a DOS screen. And what I want to do is type in ping space, the number that you configure. You want to have an Ethernet wire, Ethernet cable available. Put it into this labeled 10 base T. You always want to wait and make sure that it connects up to the CMM321 using this LAN LED. Once that's blinking, you've got a connection. You go ahead and hit enter, and you should get a response. There's going to be 4 pings, 4 replies, and they'll have the amount of milliseconds the replies take. They usually range between 3 and 10 milliseconds. Another thing that you want to do in this particular device is test the AAUI port. This is a Ethernet transceiver. You see the cable goes in here. I'm going to connect up. And underneath of the device, and I can show you more clearly later, this plugs in. Same thing, we want to make sure that the LED starts to blink. Right now it's just solid, and now it's blinking, so we're okay. You can just hit the up arrow key, and it'll bring up the same prompt that you want, which is pinging that same number. Hit enter. And again, same thing, it's gonna ping it 4 times, 4 responses. As long as I get a reply every time, there's no glitches, I can go ahead and do it again. No glitch. And one thing I wanna point out that I always do, and I'm gonna mention this in a lot of different scenarios, is I always test the test equipment. So I'll disconnect my cable and I'll go ahead and try and ping it again. What I'm looking for here is that I haven't cross-referenced with another device in the building somewhere. So if I hit enter, I should not get a reply. This can take a couple minutes, but you're going to start to notice I've already gotten one reply, that it's timed out. There's been no response, two replies, and this will carry on again for four replies, and they should all be no. That way I'm totally sure that I've only tested this device and nothing else in the building that could be on the network. Okay, and I'm going to stop the controller, disconnect from it, show you the device itself. This is the AAUI port that's underneath, and this is the corresponding plug that plugs into it. Once again, pdfsupply.com, global supplier of industrial automation.